What's up, everybody? My name is Jacob Dietz. I am a second year PT student or physical therapy student at The Ohio State University, and I'm going to explain today how I passed the CSCS, or the Certified Strength and Conditioning Specialist exam, in approximately 2 weeks. So I'm going to give you the tips first, and then I will explain to you whether or not I think that this was applicable to everybody and how necessarily I did it and why it was unique to my situation. So tip number one, let's look at my schedule and look at my actual 2 week study plan for the CSCS. So we look here, I took the exam on November 30th of 2019. And the first time I looked at this material, I knew what the CSCS was now for a few years, but the first time I really got the book and started watching videos about the exam was about a month before. It was the end of October. Got the book, looked through it, looked at some of the topics, started having conversations about it, but I didn't actually start studying until November 11th. I took one day to really delve into the book and understand what I was getting myself into before I really booked my exam. And then if you look at the last 2 weeks, about 2 weeks out, that first week I was spending, 4 to 6 hours a day reading, taking notes, and going through the whole book. And then the last week's really where I got into the heavy 14 hours a day, 12 hours a day, studying and reviewing. Tip number one is actually to read the entire book. Yes, it's very dense. It's a huge book. I have a PDF form. Some people recommend reading it twice. I think you're fine reading it once, but then reviewing it. And you don't have to go cover to cover. I've been recommended before the exam to read the back of the book first and go back and read more of the exercise science stuff. So read the clinic or read the application stuff and then go back and read the science. I went more of, chapter 1 to 24. In retrospect, I wish, depending on your background, I wish I would have done that and read the end of the book first. A little background about myself. I have been doing personal training now for about 3 years throughout undergrad. So that definitely helped, as well as my education here at Ohio State. Being in physical therapy school, a lot of my knowledge did lend to this exam. But I did study neuroscience, and I did not have a background in exercise science or kinesiology. So you don't have to have those degrees to necessarily do well in this exam and pass. So what I mean by reading the book, I would read the book and look here at these notes I took. This is an example of the way I went through the book. This was a random chapter that I chose on sports psychology, but really bullet points. I gave myself a page or two, front and back, with three columns to take down the biggest points of each chapter. This book is super heavy in research. You don't need to know that for an exam. There is a benefit to knowing that, and I think you should. You can't just skip over it, because it will help you when you are a coach and working with athletes. But for the exam, make sure you know the big picture. And by that, write down bullet points. Really keeping myself limited to those 2 pages really helped me in the end to make sure I had a broad view of everything that was covered in the exam. The second thing is, I watched a YouTube video about the blue boxes in the book, or the purple boxes. It's like a summary of each topic in the chapter. So if you look here, the blue book right here, blue box highlights kind of the past few page or two. And I don't think you could pass the exam by just reading those boxes. I think you could do very well, get a 50 or 60% by reading just those boxes. But a lot of it is, it'll lend more to the exercise science aspect and the foundational aspects, but not as much to the application. Now, I went through and took all those boxes, and I recommend doing this. I took all those boxes, screenshots, if you have the PDF, and put them in the one document, so in my last few days, I could go back and review and make sure I had covered all of those basic topics and had the last day going in, knew all the simple topics. But you definitely need to read the whole book and take notes and extract them from the book. Another thing I did was the practice questions in the book. So I took all of the practice questions and put them in the one document. And here on the map, or on the calendar, I took my first practice exam on the 25th. So by the 25th, I was done reading the entire book once. And that's when I took my first practice exam. And I got roughly a 69% on that. And these next 2 reading notes days, those were my review days for reading and jotting down last minute notes. But I had my entire book done a week before the exam, which I do recommend. And then I retook the practice exam 4 days later on the 29th, the day before my exam, And just by reviewing, I did get my score up to, I think, like a 95. But the practice questions, I don't want to say they're easier than the exam, but they're just, you know, they're going to be more applicable in the exam. These last 3 days before the exam was really where I hit it hard. And another thing I want to, the next tip is to watch videos. Now, I'm in a strength and conditioning, you might be in this group as well. I'm in the strength and conditioning group, study group, with Matt Castoro. He is part of the movement system, or he owns the movement system. And he's been doing training now for years. And he's also passed his exam a little bit ago, but he does a phenomenal job in his 10-minute videos or in his Facebook videos or YouTube videos of explaining all the topics and really explaining the broad ideas and making sure you know them for the exam. So I recommend him checking him out. I will link the group below, but he also has a paid group, and those are like hour-long videos on each topic or chapter. And that's really what helped me pass the exam, was getting that last-minute review and ensuring that I knew all the broad topics. Really, but for you, if you don't want to join that group, search on YouTube. If you're doing, you know, the cardiac function, just watch a 5-minute video on that, you know, the system of the heart, and ensure you know that going in the exam, because you will be asked questions. As well as watching videos all over all the tests, like the T-test, the pro agility test, that really, they're 2 minutes each, but it really benefited me come to exam time to remember the parameters, remember what it tested, and remember why I would use it. The last thing for videos would be, there's some videos out there explaining, you know, rep ranges and stuff. That's great, but really stick to the book for the rep ranges, because the CSCS will be very specific to the book in that sense. Now, do I think, so my, that's how my study technique was, you know, doing the videos at the end, really reviewing all my notes and having all those summaries of each chapter that were short and concise. Do I think this is realistic for anybody to come in and take the exam in 2 weeks? No. This is a very difficult exam, and you are a professional strength and conditioning coach for a reason. This exam demands a lot of knowledge and application, more importantly, which obviously is more important out of the science. Being able to apply the science, but my background definitely lent to this. Being in physical therapy school, I pretty much had the first half of the book covered just from being in classes over the past year and a half. All the cardiac function, all of the exercise science aspects of biomechanics and levers, I've all covered that, so a lot of that was my review for me, as well as nutrition. Nutrition is about 21 questions on the exam, or 21% of the exam, I think, and I end up getting 20 out of 21 right, because I love that topic and I love nutrition, so that really helped me. But if I hadn't had that background, this 2-week study plan would not have been enough. Application-wise, because I had been training for a few years now, I definitely was more apt to be able to apply this material. But a majority of the second half of the book was new to me. So that was a challenge to learn this new basis of application, but actually being able to apply it to clients was something I had background in. And making it unique to each type of, you know, body type, or like weight and height and all that kind of stuff, and gender. So definitely practice applying all these techniques. Go through, sample, create little scenarios for yourself. You have a 17-year-old female track runner that is in the off season. Like, what kind of conditioning are you going to do? What are her rest periods going to be? But then go the exact opposite. You have a 45-year-old power lifter that is in a week out from his meet. What does his rep ranges need to be? What do his calories need to be? Get the broad picture and crack down and just practice. So do I think it's realistic study in 2 weeks? If you have no prior knowledge, I do not think it is, because it's a difficult exam and demands a lot. But if you do have a background, if you're in PT school or you've been a personal trainer for a while, you know, a month out, you can definitely sit down, study for the exam, and be confident going in that you could pass this exam and apply this material. I love studying for this. I really do think it really separates me from previous trainers that I've worked with. Of course, experience is the most important thing out of anything when it comes to humanistic aspects of training, but there is a good amount of foundational knowledge that I gained from the GIST certification. So by studying for 2 weeks, do I think I just got the certification and barely passed? No, I ended up getting an 89 on the exam composite. And I started a personal training job next week in a gym for the first time ever. And I feel like I am more prepared than ever to train actual athletes. That all being said, I wish you the best of luck. Get your study plan, look through the book, see how much you know, and then decide when you want to take when you want to take the exam. That's my number one tip, is just figure out how much you know and how well you feel, and then decide your study time. I wish you all the best of luck, and I will link the Facebook groups below. Big shout out to Matt for helping me pass this exam. Phenomenal teacher. And let me know if you all have any questions for me. I will put my email in the inbox or info box below, and I will continue to make some videos like this. So if you want more videos, please like and this video and then subscribe, and I will release more info on how to study for the CSCS exam. That all being said, good luck, and I will see you in the next video.